DLSS is certainly still better than FSR2 in most situations, but FSR 2.1 has done a good job of eliminating some ghosting that we're seeing in DLSS on this fan blade. Now, both of these are captured on my RTX 4090 at the 4K Ultra preset. You can see the performance stats here, but this isn't really focusing on the performance because we're on an RTX 4090, other than showing that these settings, the quality setting on both of them, do produce about the same frame rate. We'll get more into performance numbers when we look into some AMD GPUs at the end here, but let's get back to image quality comparisons, where again, we're seeing here DLSS quality against the native image. And again, the native does not have that ghosting trail. And this is one of the downsides to DLSS. When we look at FSR 2.1 quality against the native image, I do think it's doing a better job in this scene. Now, I'm using the DLSS and FSR versions that are built into this game, and Cyberpunk did just get updated to have FSR 2.1, and it used to have the 1.0 version. However, it's not all wins for AMD here. If we look at this one, this is an example of DLSS looking better than native. If you look at the shimmering of the building in the distance, the native image is less stable, and the FSR 2.1 image is significantly less stable. For those of you not on a 4K screen, here's a 2x linear zoom, which actually makes a 4K image zoomed into where like this would look like 1080p, like native pixel numbers, whatever. Anyway, you get the idea. It's easier to see now if you're on a less high resolution screen. And again, that building certainly looks much less stable. However, here we're looking at DLSS, and this is actually, in my opinion, when I'm actually playing the game, the most annoying thing about DLSS. What am I looking at? I'm looking at the lines in the pavement. They kind of shimmer and look unstable in motion. It's subtle, but it's annoying, and it even happens when I'm standing still here. Now, the native image isn't perfectly stable, but it's more stable than DLSS. So again, while we saw DLSS look better than native in that last scene, when people say DLSS looks better than native, period, they're just wrong. There are pros and cons, but it's not strictly better. When we look at FSR 2.1 here, I feel like there's less of those issues in the pavement lines, but there's a different problem. Look at the, I don't know, this isn't really a rug here, but do you see the like moiré patterns going on there in the FSR 2.1 image? Maybe we should do some side-by-sides for a little better comparison here. So you don't get to see the full screen, but you can at least see them all side-by-side here, and you can see some performance stats again, in case you're interested in the performance numbers. But again, you'd only consider using the FSR 2 when you had DLSS 2.3 if you felt FSR 2 just strictly looked better than DLSS. And well, hey, we're investigating that in this video, but spoilers, I do still think DLSS is all around a better upscaler. But FSR 2.1 is getting pretty close here. And again, those lines in the pavement were really annoying in that scene. But honestly, upscalers have more trouble in motion. Now, I was trying to find an actual fighting scene in this game that I could keep somewhat side by side. So I decided to go with this car chase, because it's on rails and scripted. So aside from the fact that I aim better with FSR, apparently, apologies for the aim on the DLSS side of things, you can now see both of them in motion. I do think that FSR looks a little bit more, I don't know how to put it, like fizzly in motion. That's not a real technical term. But honestly, when you're actually playing the game in a gunfight, I'm not really thinking about it, and I think they both look pretty good. So at 4K, I do think both of them are doing a good job here. Now, for those of you not on a 4K screen, here's the same clip, but we're now zooming in again with a 2x linear zoom, 4x pixel zoom. Anyway, this should look fine on a 1080p screen now. You're seeing more of what you can actually see on the 4K screen. And again, in motion, I do think, again, that DLSS, just as objects come into view, they're disoccluded, that kind of a thing. Just in general, I think it's a small edge, but honestly, it's so close that YouTube compression's probably killing the difference. And honestly, I'm nitpicking the differences here. When I'm actually playing the game in an actual gunfight and not just looking around at the scenery, in this scene, I think things looked pretty good. Now, what we're going to look at here is the built-in benchmark, because if we want to get some exact side-by-side captures, the built-in benchmark is the easiest place to do that. And here I think I can see a little more instability in the FSR 2.1 image. Look at the little arrows on the little on the yellow sign there. I guess it's a little unstable on both of them, but when it was further back at a distance, I saw a little more instability, I think, in the FSR 2.1 image. Honestly, in that bar scene, though, I think both of them looked pretty good. Now, as we turn the corner here, look at the, I don't know if it's a chain link fence, but the fence in the distance as we go a little bit further down here. And I feel like that fencing that we see right there is more stable on the DLSS image. But both of them, you know, are looking pretty close. Also, take a look at the palm tree branches, especially as they get shown in the sunlight here. The palm tree branches are more stable on the DLSS side. So once again, I feel like if you have the choice of using either tech, which you do on an NVIDIA RTX GPU, I do think that the RTX GPU is the one to choose. However, you know, let's try it out on a more aggressive setting. So far, we've just been looking at the quality setting, which looks the best. But what if you use this more aggressively? Now, here my 4090 is probably going to get kind of CPU limited, but that's not the point. This isn't really a performance test. This is an image quality test. And again, I think they're both doing an admirable job here. But I do think, once again, that the DLSS image quality is better. And I actually think it's accentuated at this resolution. Now, during that initial bar scene, I thought both of them were doing a pretty good job. But the same issues that we saw before, the same differences, I think get exaggerated or more pronounced, like the fencing here in the distance and like the fan and the palm tree branches in the distance. That's where I'm really noticing it. And again, if you're not on a 4K screen, well, we'll do some lower resolution tests in a second here. But the palm tree branches, especially right now, are looking a lot more stable on the DLSS side. Although, to be honest, I don't like the performance upscaling on either of them. I would rather just turn down graphics settings if that was an option for me. So, not a huge fan of either one. I do think DLSS looks better and more so at the more aggressive settings. But let's go down to 1440p. So hey, if you have a 1440p monitor, you're now actually seeing some native image quality to look at here. This, the performance-wise, we're basically CPU limited here. The 4090 at 1440p gets pretty CPU bottlenecked here. The bottles, by the way, back there, speaking of bottlenecks, I think that's one place where you can see a difference in the upscaling. And then again, as we go out through this alleyway, like I said, especially look at the distance, look at the fencing, look at the palm tree branches, things like that. I think those are places where we notice more of those differences. And again, I do think it's going in DLSS's advantage, although both of them are usable here. Again, the fencing here in motion, I feel like is less stable on the FSR side of things. And again, now that you're on a, if you're on a 1440p screen, you're now at least able to see this at that native image quality. Although, once again, I have to remind you guys that YouTube compression, like, I'm on YouTube, this is what I can give you guys, but YouTube compression does diminish some of the differences that you would see here if you were actually watching this on your own screen natively. We just lose some of the tiny little details and crispness. And that's where the, a lot of these differences show up. But anyway, if you're on a 1080p screen, you can now see both upscaling techniques compared here. And again, at the lower resolutions, I do think DLSS takes a bit more of an edge. Again, the lower the resolution is, I think the differences become more apparent. Again, it's not completely blowing FSR 2.1 out of the water. I think they're fairly close. But again, I think the plants right there looked a little bit more stable with DLSS. And again, as we can start to see the fencing in the background here, the palm tree branches, all of that stuff, I think the image is more stable on the DLSS side. So anyway, I think we're establishing here pretty well that DLSS is still better than FSR 2.1. I think most people expected that. I think it was cool to see some advantages like we saw in the fan blade at the beginning, where we saw FSR 2.1 do a better job with ghosting and things like that. But let's go to what this is actually probably going to be used for, which is GPUs that don't support DLSS. So this is the RX 6800 XT, running at the 4K high preset. On the left-hand side, we can see the native performance and image quality, and on the right-hand side, we can see the FSR 2.1 quality setting upscale. First of all, notice the performance difference. We're going from well below 60 FPS to well above 60 FPS. Like, it's a huge performance impact, and it makes the 6800 XT definitely able to play this game at good settings at 4K, so it's really quite impressive. And again, the quality upscale at the 4K resolution, image quality-wise, it does look very good. I can see on my screen, again, I'm on a large 4K 48-inch screen, so it's like a zoomed-in version for me just because how big and how close it is. And again, I'm not dealing with the YouTube compression. I can tell the native image does look slightly better, but it's not a massive, massive difference. And the performance impact there is huge. Look at those numbers. Now, this is an imperfect test. I wanted to compare FSR 1.0 versus 2.1 in this game, but after updating the game, I couldn't switch it back to 1.0. So what I'm showing you on the left-hand side is footage I captured, I think, a month or two ago. So it was an older version of the game, and it was an older graphics driver. So this is not as perfect of an apples-to-apples comparison as I would like it to be, but it was captured on the same GPU, and I am using the driver software at the same settings to capture the footage. One thing that's interesting here is the performance is about the same. It's not identical, but it's pretty close. And I do, again, think that on my screen, I'm not dealing with YouTube compression, on the large 4K screen, like text, like on the sign I'm looking at right now, the text is absolutely clearer and sharper with the newer upscaler, with the FSR 2.1. So if you have the choice between the two, in my opinion, the 2.1 certainly beats 1.0. We can see the performance here came out almost identically. And again, different graphics drivers and all that. Let's go back to testing native versus FSR 2.1. And this is now 1440p. We're on the ultra preset now. Again, this is the RX 6800 XT, and we're back to the footage I just captured today. So this is the native versus 2.1, same graphics drivers, same version of the game, all of that. And, performance jump, we're definitely getting a performance boost on the right-hand side. And image quality-wise, again, now that you're on a more of you would probably be on a 1440p screen than we're on the 4K screen, so it's easier for you to spot. But again, I feel like there's on the fencing there, a little bit more instability on the FSR image. I feel like I'm just repeating myself now at this point. Again, look at the palm tree branches. They're more stable on the native image quality than they are on the FSR 2.1 image quality. So it's not free performance. There is an image quality hit by enabling FSR 2.1, but it is a nice performance boost, as we can see here. And you know what? It's not a massive image quality hit. Now, what I wanted to look at here was, what if you used FSR 2.1 more aggressively at the 1440p setting and did it to try to enable ray tracing? So notice that on the left-hand side, we have FSR 2.1 quality. We're at 1440p. On the right-hand side, we have FSR 2.1 performance. So it's a very aggressive upscale. It's coming from a very low resolution. And this is the ray tracing ultra preset. Now, the quality setting could not make this a 60 FPS experience on the AMD GPU. It's ray tracing, it's the ultra settings, guys. This is tough even for NVIDIA GPUs. FSR 2.1 performance mode is getting us more of that like 60 FPS type experience. But again, if YouTube compression isn't completely killing it, I'll tell you right now, like look at the palm tree branches again. There's instability just from FSR 2.1 quality, but it is noticeably worse with the FSR 2.1 performance mode. So again, you are taking a bigger image quality hit, but it is interesting to see that you can get a 60 FPS average. You certainly dip below it, but 60 FPS average, ray tracing ultra preset on the RX 6800 XT. But why don't we drop down to a more mid-range GPU? So let's look at the 6600 XT. And let's look at 1080p. We're seeing the native image on the left, and we're seeing FSR 2.1 quality setting on the right. And again, this is now the 6600 XT. I think the bar here and the bottles in the background was one place that you could see a lot more shimmering on the right-hand side, so less stability to the image. And in general, I don't like using upscaling tech when I'm at 1080p. A lot of the details just start to look fuzzier to me. There's a lot less stability to the image. And I think at the higher resolutions, these upscaling tech just has more to work with. Like, look at the trees in the background right now on the right-hand side. You know, it just, I would prefer at 1080p to try turning down normal settings rather than use the upscaling techniques. But as GPUs age, it's going to be really nice to have this option available because, you know, it doesn't look horrible. I just wouldn't use it if I had, you know, other good options. So I think what this is really more interesting to look at is taking a GPU like the 6600 XT, which is really designed as like a 1080p Ultra type GPU. At least it was, you know, a year or so ago. As new games come out, they might struggle at 1080p Ultra, but still be a good 1080p GPU. This can play games at 1440p, but it struggles. We can see here that at the Ultra preset, which again, you don't have to play on Ultra, and we will definitely look at that, but at the Ultra preset, we're well below 60 FPS on the 1440p native. I was kind of interested to see if FSR 2.1 quality setting, which is, like I said, an image quality hit, but it does look pretty close to native. It's a little less stable if we look at the fencing and the palm tree branches. I was hoping it would get us to around 60 FPS, but as you guys can see, that isn't happening here. So we're gonna have to play around with the settings a little bit more. So it's not just a quick, you know, click FSR 2.1 quality and get yourself 60 FPS at 1440p Ultra, but that was probably hoping for a little bit too much. So we can see the performance numbers here. It did give us a healthy boost, especially percentage-wise, if you just don't think of it in terms of absolute FPS, but as a percentage. But if we go down to the high preset, now we're getting a boost from going down to the high settings as well as FSR 2.1 quality. And now we see on the right-hand side, we're pretty much locked to over 60 FPS experience. And on the left-hand side, with the high preset at the native, we're still down in the 40s right now. So you can see that FSR 2.1 quality is putting in a lot of work here. And I haven't ran the numbers percentage-wise, but I feel like we're getting a larger percentage boost here from the same FSR setting at high settings than we got at Ultra settings. So I wonder if there's something about the Ultra settings which is, you know, getting us less of a boost from reducing the resolution. I'm not an expert on how this engine works, you know, or anything like that, but it feels like we're getting a larger boost here. I mean, I get we're getting a boost from the high setting, but even just from native to quality here, seems a bit better. But either way, we're up at 69, nice, I guess it would round to 70, average now, compared to 48 average on the native. Now, I was interested to see if going down to the medium settings at 1440p would get us 60 FPS at the native resolution. And while we will be over 60 FPS through parts of this benchmark, in this difficult bar scene, we are not. But kicking on FSR 2.1 quality, we're actually at a pretty high refresh rate experience. I mean, it's not, you know, competitive eSport type frame rates, but for a single player RPG, I mean, yeah, it's a first person shooter, but it's a single player one with a lot of time spent just walking around and talking. I mean, being up here in the 80s and 90 FPS range at 1440p on a 6600 XT feels pretty good. Although again, look at the decreased stability to the image on the right-hand side. I feel like once again, the palm tree branches stand out as one of the more obvious things to look at, but the other foliage and just distant details and things like that are other places you can look here. But man, it's getting us quite a big performance boost for that slight reduction to image quality here. Again, we were below 60 FPS average at the medium setting. Now, since we never got to a 60 FPS you know, average, let alone minimums, even going down to medium, we're now going down to the low settings on the left-hand side native. But what I'm showing you is on the right-hand side, I wanted to look at what I think, you know, how I think we should think about FSR and DLSS for that matter, is it's another graphic setting to tweak. Turning it on is making your image slightly worse, but so is turning down graphic settings. So the choice is, which graphic setting do you want to turn down? Here, we're looking at the difference between going down to the low settings and running at the native image, or staying at the medium settings and running at the FSR 2.1 quality setting. You get a little less stability to the image on the right-hand side, but other graphic settings are still turned higher. So I think your shadows and other various things still look better. And this is where FSR, I think, gives us some interesting choices. And overall, I'm really happy to see it added to Cyberpunk here, and I hope to see more and more games continuing to get FSR 2.1, and I'm excited to see further versions of FSR. Hope all of you have an excellent day.